Thank you, everybody, for coming to the Aaron Torres Podcast YouTube page. I do have one quick favor before we get to the video that you came here for, and that is very simply this. You see that little red subscribe button below this video? Go ahead, smash that subscribe button. It really does help me. It really does help this channel grow and my audience grow. So go ahead and hit that red subscribe button. And now, here is the video that you came here for. But over the course of the weekend, I do think there were two teams that really kind of jumped into the conversation, as I said, joined the text, joined the group chat of, we're a really proud program, and we really kind of stink right now. The first was Kansas, the second was Michigan State, and we'll get into Michigan State in a minute because I do think their problems are a little bit more like Kentucky's and Duke's, whereas Kansas is a completely different problem altogether, and I think it's a problem that portends to bigger picture issues for this program going forward, all stemming from the FBI stuff. But before we get into that, just kind of some context for people who weren't in front of their TV all day on Saturday. Kansas went to Tennessee and got absolutely annihilated. And this is, for the record, a very good Tennessee team, but also a Tennessee that in its own right was struggling. We're going to talk about Tennessee in a minute, but they came into this one having lost two of their last three games. And even the game that they won was against Mississippi State, and that was kind of a grind it out, drag them down, knock them out fight. So for Tennessee to just crush Kansas and look like the significantly better team, maybe it speaks to Tennessee turning a corner, but it also speaks to the fact that Kansas isn't very good right now. With the loss, Kansas has now lost four of their last five games. Their only win in that stretch was against TCU, and by the way, they had 18 points in that game, but they're really, really, really struggling. And I think it's funny, I was going to actually talk about Kansas's struggles last week, and then the whole blue blood conversation happened with Villanova fans, so it got pushed to the side. But I think you can make a legitimate case that Kansas is like the sixth or seventh best teams in the Big 12 right now. When you look at the Big 12, first of all, Kansas sitting there at 11-6 overall, 5-4 in the conference standings. I know the Tennessee loss didn't count towards the conference standings, but this is a program that's trending in the right direction. And you look at the rest of that league, we know Baylor and Texas are significantly better than Kansas right now. We know that Oklahoma and Oklahoma State, while historically they haven't been on Kansas's level, they've both beat Kansas in recent weeks. We know Texas Tech is rolling. And we know West Virginia is playing pretty well, even though they lost to Florida. And so maybe you can make the argument that Kansas is a little bit better than West Virginia right now. They ain't better than Baylor, though. They ain't better than Texas right now. I know they beat Texas Tech earlier this year. They ain't better than Texas Tech right now. And they just lost to Oklahoma and Oklahoma State. And so you're talking about a program that at best is 5th, 6th, 7th in their conference. Now, I will say in defense of Kansas, before we get into what's wrong, can it get fixed, and why I think this program is absolutely headed in the wrong direction, it is worth noting that unlike Duke, unlike Michigan State, unlike Kentucky, they are still in position to make the NCAA tournament, right? Like they still have an 11-6 record overall. They still have some quality wins from the early season. Most of them happened in December and early January, whether it was the Kentucky game in the Champions Classic, the Creighton game in the Gavitt games, early wins in the Big 12 against West Virginia and Texas Tech, but it doesn't change the fact that right now this team is not very good. And so when I look at this team, again, their goal, just like at Kentucky and Duke, is not to make the NCAA tournament. It's to win once you get there. So I think while this team will make the NCAA tournament, there are still some bigger picture issues, and so let's get into them. You know, first of all, there are the on-the-court basketball issues, and When I look at this team, you know, there are things that they're just not doing well right now, right? First and foremost, they are not rebounding the ball at any kind of clip that you need to win at the highest level. Got out-rebounded by 15 against Kansas, against Tennessee. They got out-rebounded by 10 against Oklahoma. You're not going to win games against good teams when you're getting out-rebounded by 10, 15 rebounds. They're also not shooting the ball very well. 6 of 21 from 3 against Tennessee is not going to get the job done, let alone when you're talking about a team that shot 37% from the field, and a lot of those shots came late when the game was already out of hand. Again, 18 first-half points against TCU, 26 first-half points against Tennessee, a 14-point deficit at halftime against Tennessee. That is not going to get the job done against good teams. So I think that there are like the little issues. But then there's the big picture issue, which is that if you watch this Kansas team, it just doesn't look like a vintage Kansas team. And so because of that, it kind of got me thinking, like, I just don't think this team is very good. And I think we can say one thing definitively. I think we can say that the FBI probe and the recruiting impact that it had is absolutely finally having an impact on Kansas. And I'm not saying you should feel sorry for Bill Self. We'll talk about, you know, the long-term big picture ramifications in a minute. Not saying anybody should throw a pity party for Bill Self. But I think the FBI probe has finally caught up with them in terms of just the talent that they have on this roster. And so I went to actually look it up. And I will give somebody credit. Jeff Goodman has actually already done the legwork. But the stats and figures about Kansas's recruiting are largely reflected in what is going on right now, and it's directly correlating to what is going on the court for Kansas. So Jeff Goodman went back a number of years and looked at Kansas's recruiting rankings and their number of elite recruits in each class. And what I'll do is I'll go year by year just to kind of emphasize how bad it's gotten, how quickly. And I'll say that, you know, I think top 50 prospects are important, because those are the guys that can come into college and have a major impact. If it's not as a one and done, in a second, third year, those are the guys that win you basketball games, right? Others, you know, there are schools that can recruit top 150 kids and turn them into stars, but not everybody can. You want the elite players if you can get them. And for a long time, you know, pre-FBI, Kansas was doing it. 2013, that was the Andrew Wiggins, Joel Embiid year. Five top 50 prospects that they signed. 2014, the following year, three top 50 prospects that they signed, including Devontae Graham, who is now having a very successful NBA career. 2015, two top 50 prospects signed. 2016, two top 50 prospects signed. 2017, three of the top 55 signed. And the 2017 class is important to note because it was the last class that signed before any of the FBI stuff came out, right? FBI stuff starts to come out in the fall of 2017 into 2018, and it didn't really impact Kansas's recruiting in the 2018 class, where they signed three top 50 kids, including Devon Dotson, who was essentially an All-American last year, Quentin Grimes, who was awesome but then ended up transferring, and David McCormick, who is actually still in the program. But 2018 is where you kind of see the drop-off, right? Once you get to 2018, it ain't pretty. 2019 class, zero top 50 prospects. And then the 2020 class, which is the current freshman class, how about this? Just one top 150 prospect, and that was a kid named Bryce Thompson, and he only committed to Kansas because his dad played for Bill Self in college years ago. And so you look at Kansas's problems, it directly correlates to their junior and senior classes, or their sophomore and junior classes, excuse me, which is where the bulk of success comes in college basketball, being caught up kind of post-FBI, and then there were no elite freshmen because they were all afraid to sign with Kansas in this high school class of 2020 as we knew things were ramping up. And so you look at this Kansas team now, it shouldn't be a surprise that this team is struggling. There are simply teams in this conference and certainly in college basketball that are more talented than them. You look at their team right now, here is what you need to know. Of their top scorers this year for the University of Kansas, leading scorer Ochai Agbaji, who I actually think Bill Self has done a good job developing, he was ranked the 132nd ranked player in his recruiting class coming out of high school. Bill Self has actually done a good job developing him. I'm not here to just tear down Bill Self, you know, without any rhyme or reason. Ochai Agbaji is going to be an NBA player, but he still was ranked 132nd ranked player in his high school class. Second leading scorer, Jalen Wilson, 53rd ranked player in his high school class. He only ends up at Kansas because Jalen Wilson was supposed to go to Michigan. John Beilein leaves for the NBA. He's looking for a new home. He ends up at Kansas, and he's coming off a major knee injury. David McCormick, part of that last high school class that was, not really impacted by the FBI probe. And then you have a bunch of other guys that really were not very highly ranked recruits. And so I think when you look at it, it directly correlates to why Kansas is struggling. They just don't have the talent that not only Kansas traditionally has, but, oh, by the way, the rest of the Big 12 has. And so when I look at it in the big picture, I don't know how this gets any better. And I will say this. First of all, as far as, like I said a minute ago, I know nobody's throwing any pity parties for Bill Self, and I don't think we should make any excuses for him. I actually think, to a degree, to his credit, he overachieved early in the season. But I do think what he is accused of and what his staff is accused of doing is finally coming full circle. Never forget, there was a report that came out this weekend from The Athletic that we now have more documentation that one of the assistant coaches admitted knowing that a recruit got some money when it came to their recruitment. He wasn't even talking about a Kansas player, but the bottom line is it's no secret that based on what we know, based on what came out in those FBI trials, there was some stuff involved involving Kansas, and it has hurt their recruiting. Now, I'll say about Bill Self, what I say about Sean Miller and Will Wade. I am not going to definitively get up here and say he needs to be fired. He needs to go. Let's wait till all the facts come out, but the bottom line is it ain't looking pretty. And so when I look at this Kansas situation, this isn't about a weird year or a COVID year or starts and stops to the season or players missing time because of COVID. This is the FBI probe hits in 2017, 2018 you sign a great class, and then right after that there's a big drop-off. And here's the scary part if you're a Kansas fan. I don't know how it gets better. 2021 class, I went ahead and looked it up. They have two players signed. One is ranked the 39th ranked player in the country, and he's from Kansas. And then he got the 71st ranked player in the country. And, you know, he's another guy that's probably going to be a project. And so when you look at what's going on, how does it get better? Because you're not bringing in those elite high school prospects anymore. Your recruiting has been hurt. And unless you just strike gold in the transfer portal with a bunch of kids that just want to play at Kansas, I don't know how this gets better. I would say on top of that, even if you do strike gold, guess what? Bill Self is a guy historically that you need to be in his program for 2, 3, 4 years before you develop into the player that you're capable of being. But when I look at Kansas, when I look at where they're at now, when I look at how they're recruiting, I don't see how it gets better, especially when you factor in the Big 12 ain't slowing down, man. Baylor is awesome and bringing in the best recruiting class that they ever have. Texas Tech, Chris Beard, I think he's a magician at how he gets these transfers to buy in and have success right away. Not only Mac McClung this year, but a couple years ago, Matt Mooney, Tariq Owens led him to a Final Four. Texas, for at least 1 year, is recruiting well. Oklahoma is even Steven. They never drop off. And so if you're Kansas, I don't think it gets better. Now, they're going to make the NCAA tournament. They're not on the outside looking in like some of these other blue blood and elite programs. But I'm just telling you right now, flat out, I don't think this gets better. I don't think it happens anytime soon.